Hello, value investors. Thank you for joining me. Today I want to talk about Viacom CBS and why I believe that it's probably fairly valued. So if you're new to the channel, please subscribe now so you can get my next value installment. Also, don't forget to do a free trial on my marketplace to find out which stocks I own and why. So let's get started. So here's the thing. Viacom's management don't have a lot of skin in the game. You can see that their ownership is less than 1% of the stock. You do have the chairman, Redstone, that has a huge percentage of ownership. However, the management itself doesn't have a lot. Having said that, starting 2020, they have bought, several directors have bought quite a lot of stock. So on the one hand, they don't own a lot of stock right now, but they did deploy up to about 200K. So it is possible that they believe it's undervalued. The issue is that advertising is quite weak at the moment. So if you look, these are the results up to March. And if you remember, the lockdown really only came into its full effect towards the latter parts of March. So you got April that got things in the advertising market really came down significantly, and it's only now starting to stabilize. And this word that a lot of companies are using about stabilization, it simply means that it's not tightening up further. So we are still expecting to see how Q2 has come out, but it's not going to look a lot better than this, I think. And the idea is that Viacom should be able to, in 2020, make $1.8 billion in free cash flow. And I'm just not that positive that it may. Realistically, we have to think about its balance sheet. So this is up to March again. This is from the 10Q. And you can see it has $18 billion of debt outstanding. Now, you have to bear in mind that since the end of March, Viacom CBS has been quite active in the debt market, but for all intents and purposes, even though it's pushed back some of its debt and the interest on that new debt is lower, it's still, for all intents and purposes, hovering around this $18 billion, $19 billion of debt outstanding. So it's quite tricky for us to even contemplate paying a very large multiple for a company that is still trying to pivot to its online distribution. So with Viacom, the idea is that they're going to be streamlined now. So they're getting rid of their headquarters, BlackRock, possibly for around $1 billion, and they're getting rid of their publishing unit. And I think that this publishing unit may sell for around 800 to 800 million to $1 billion, because it's a flat business. It's not really growing. The margins on the publishing unit continue to compress over time, so it's difficult to see that being sold, that asset being divested at a very large multiple. It may fetch around, let's say, 800 to $1 billion, but it's going to be difficult to sell for a lot more than that. So you sell those two assets and you're going to still be left in a position that it's really difficult for it to get paid down its balance sheet. So you got a company that makes possibly around 1.3 billion of free cash flow, and it's going to be very, very difficult for it to be re-rated at a significantly higher multiple. So this is the icing on the cake for investors. Investors are hoping that the streaming platform will really take off. Investors are hoping that Viacom CBS domestic streaming platform grows significantly, but it's growing from a very low base. So this is not very much supportive of the bullish thesis, in my opinion, because it's such a small base. So also you have to bear in mind that the streaming platform is nowhere near as profitable as its previous linear platform. So in the past, Viacom CBS, before the merger, it was able to kind of get close to 20% operating margins. And I don't think that in a streaming world where everyone is competing with the likes of Netflix, that it's going to be able to come anywhere near the 20%. So you're going to have a less profitable, possibly growing platform, but less profitable. And paying approximately 9 times multiple for Viacom CBS is quite a reasonable multiple, in my opinion. It may have some wiggle room. It could certainly, as investors start to price in the potential of its growing streaming platform, it could get slightly higher multiple. But then you got to think about the fact that it's going to have less free cash flow as well over time. So before the merger, the idea was that with all the synergies, that Viacom CBS could make approximately 2.3, 2.5 billion of free cash flow. And then investors started thinking about putting a 10x multiple on that. So thinking, okay, Viacom CBS could trade for about 25 billion. But it's difficult for that because there's so much competition in the market for streaming right now. So on the one hand, it has a lot of debt. On the other hand, there's the idea that a streaming platform could really grow. So on balance, I believe it's close to fairly valued. So as always, I hope you found this video useful. Check out my marketplace called Deep Value Returns. See if you want to do a free trial on there, and you can find out which stocks I own and why. I offer a balanced argument for the stocks that I own. Thank you for listening. All the best.